Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss Unit 3.2, A Lesson in Life from a Beggar. A very nice and inspirational story written by famous Indian writer Sudha Murthy. Let me tell you one thing, that actually we have completed this unit, this chapter, in our classrooms, in our face-to-face classes. But some students are not coming to school. That's why for those students who miss this unit, I am here online for you. Okay, let us discuss thoroughly what the story is. Actually, we have already discussed, but again, try to remember it very well. In the beginning, let us discuss some warming up activities. Chit chat, make small groups and share a piece of advice that stopped a bad habit in you. We know that as a student, you have many good habits as well as you have also some bad habits. Each and every person has such type of habits. Now tell me a piece of advice that stopped a bad habit in you. You can tell your experience also. You can also say that actually as a student, I used to wake up late in the morning. But one day, my mom told me the importance of waking up early in the morning. Or she also told me how the great people used to wake up early in the morning. I listened to my mom and that piece of advice helped me. Now I wake up early in the morning and I can do all my work daily. Okay, you can say like this. Now second, a quote, proverb that you love to use often. We know that many people, while talking to each other, they use some quotations or they use some proverbs. Now tell me your favorite proverb or your favorite quote. You can say that quote like this: the roots of education are bitter, but the fruits are sweeter. Okay. Or you can say a proverb like this: early to bed, early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. You can share your own proverb or quote. Next, an experience that taught you a lifelong lesson. We know that we have also undergo such type of experiences that changes our life. Okay, can you tell me such type of experience? Okay, you can share this question with your friends. A story, news episode, movie, play that has impressed and changed you. You have to tell me any story, any news, any episode from TV serial, movie, any movie or play that has impressed and changed you. We know that many such type of stories and movies are there. Motivational and inspiring stories and movies are there. You can tell anyone. Okay. Now next one. Many slang expressions, terms are used for people having positive or negative traits. Some slang expressions. Slang means expressions in rural areas. Actually, they are not formal expressions, but just like informal expressions used by common people. They are called as slang expressions. Match the expressions in column A with type of persons in column B. Okay, A and B. B, A, brilliant, genius. B, very energetic or active. C, shameful person. D, lazy, good for nothing. E, spoils other people's fun mood. एफ ऑलवेज नर्वस वरीड जी ओल्ड फैशनड और रिफ्यूजेस चेंज यू हैव टू मैच द पेयर्स टेक आउट योर इंग्लिश बुक्स एंड ट्राई टू मैच ए एंड बी स्लैंग एक्सप्रेशंस विद देयर मीनिंग्स एज शोन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक यू हैव टू मैच विथ मी फर्स्ट वन इज काउच पोटैटो हुम डज वी कॉल काउच पोटैटो द आंसर इज डी लेजी और गुड फॉर नथिंग अ लेजी पर्सन इज कॉल्ड एज काउच पोटैटो सेकेंड वरी वार्ट मीन्स दैट इज यफ ऑलवेज नर्वस और वरीड सम पीपल आर ऑलवेज नर्वस एंड वरीड सच पीपल आर कॉल्ड एज वरी वार्ट इन स्लैंग एक्सप्रेशन थर्ड फडी डडी द करेक्ट आंसर इज जी ओल्ड फैशनड और रिफ्यूजेस चेंज वी नो दैट सम अवर ओल्ड पीपल दैट मीन्स अवर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स ग्रेट ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स दे डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू चेंज न्यू आइडियाज दोज पीपल आर कॉल्ड एज फडी डडी नेक्स्ट फॉर वेट ब्लैंकेट The answer is E. Spoils other people's fun or mood. Fifth, Viz. Viz means brilliant or genius person is called as Viz. Sixth, Black Sheep. Black Sheep. C. Shameful person is called as Black Sheep. Seven, Live Wire. Live Wire means just like electric current is going on. That person is called as B, that is very energetic or active person is called as live wire. Okay. Now second question. Discuss with your group and write the difference in reactions of an optimist and pessimist. Some situations are given here. Now you have to tell me how a pessimist as well as how an optimist behave in this situation. First situation is given failure in exam or tests. Optimist means, what does optimist mean? Optimist means a person who expects the best. That person is called as optimist. And pessimist means a person who expects the worst. That person is called as pessimist. The first situation is given here. Failure in exams or tests. What will the optimist say? The optimist will say that or he learns from mistakes. When he fails in the examination, he or she learns from the mistakes. How will the pessimist behave? He or she blames others for his failure. Okay, that is the quality or behavior of the pessimist. Next, second situation, lose a good amount of cash. Suppose a person loses a good amount of cash. Then if he is an optimist, then he decides to be careful in future. He decides to be careful in future. And what about the pessimist? He blames the situation or the people around him. Okay. Then next situation, unexpected rainfall or bad weather. If there is unexpected rainfall or bad weather, optimist keeps his mood fresh. If the weather is bad or it is unexpected rainfall, and pessimist gets annoyed that, oh, it is raining, I have to go outside, I have to do that work like this. Next, illness. If a person falls ill, if he is optimist, he tries to recover and feels happy. He tries to recover and feels happy. And the pessimist thinks it will take more time to recover, or think that due to illness I am missing so many things. He thinks like this. And the last one, extra classes in school. If there are extra classes in school, your teacher has called you on Sunday or holiday, then if a student is optimist, he thinks that it is an opportunity for me to learn more. And if the student is pessimist, he thinks it is a burden and he complains about it. Okay, these are the situations and expected answers by the optimist and pessimist people. Now let's see the actual story, A Lesson in Life from a Beggar. Very nice story written by great Indian writer Sudha Murthy. She is an inspirational and motivational writer, speaker. And actually we are very lucky that we are going to learn the story written by her. And in this story, she is narrating her own experience with one of her friends. And from that incident, from that experience, we know that what type of people are there around us. Now, let us see. A Lesson in Life from a Beggar. Meena is a good friend of mine. She is an LIC officer earning a good salary. The writer is giving her friend's example. She is telling us that Meena, who is one of her friends, and what is she? She is an LIC officer and she has also a good salary. But there was always something strange about her. She was forever unhappy. Meena was actually a good girl, a good lady. She has a good salary. But what is the problem with her? That she was forever unhappy. She was always something strange about her. That means she was forever unhappy. Whenever I met her, I would start to feel depressed. The writer says that whenever she met her, she felt depressed. Actually, whenever we meet our friends, we became fresh. Okay, we become happy. But here, whenever the writer meets her friend Meena, she becomes sad. She becomes depressed. It was as though her gloom and cynicism had a way of spreading to others. She never had anything positive to say on any subject or about any person. It was as though her gloom and cynicism had a way of spreading others. Gloom means, here gloom means feeling of sadness. And cynicism means a distrustful attitude. Actually, it was her own attitude that how to behave with others. That means she never had anything positive to say on any subject or about any person. That means she was a negative-minded lady. She did not hope best in future. Whenever she is doing something, she hope that she will face problems in future. That means a negative-minded person. Now the writer is giving the examples how she behaves in different situations. For instance, I might say to her, Meena, did you know Rakesh has come first in his school? Meena, did you know Rakesh has come first in his school? Then Meena's immediate response would be to belittle the achievement. Belittle means to minimize the importance of that achievement. Then she would say that naturally his father is a school teacher. She would say, when a question is asked to Meena, Meena, did you know Rakesh has come first in the school? Then whenever someone says to us like this, we give a positive response. How nice, what a genius boy Rakesh is, like this. But Meena's response is different than other persons, other people. She said that, what's then? His father is a teacher. That's why he may have come first in the class. Means a negative-minded person's response is like this. If I said, Meena, Shweta is a very beautiful girl, isn't she? Meena would be pessimistic. When a pony is young, he looks handsome. It is age that matters. Wait for some time. Shweta will be uglier than anyone you know. That means here, another example is given. If someone says to Meena that, Meena, do you know Shweta is a very beautiful girl, isn't she? Oh, yes, yes, she is a beautiful. She won't say like this. Instead of saying such type of positive remark, she says that when a pony is young, pony means a race horse, a baby of a race horse. When it is young, it looks handsome. It is age that matters. Wait for some time. Shweta will be uglier than any other girl. That means she doesn't give any positive response. She is a negative minded lady. And that's why the writer Sudha Murthy is giving her example to all of us. Meena, it's a beautiful day. Let's go for a walk. When we ask Meena, Meena, oh, what a beautiful day. Let's go for a walk. No, the sun is too hot and I get tired if I walk too much. Besides, who says walking is good for health? There's no proof. Again, such type of negative response by Meena. Oh, it is very hot day. And who says that walking is good for health? There is no proof, says Meena. That means she gives such type of negative response to each and every situation, to each and every question. That was Meena. This is all about Meena. From this passage, we learned that Meena is an LIC officer. She has a good salary, but she is a pessimistic lady. She is a negative minded lady. She never thinks positive. She never gives positive responses. That was Meena. She stayed alone in an apartment as her parents lived in Delhi. Actually, she was unmarried. She lived alone in an apartment and her parents lived in Delhi. She was an only child and had the habit of complaining about anything and everything. And let me tell you that she was the only child to her parents and she has a habit of complaining about something or everything. Naturally, she wasn't a very pleasant company and nobody wanted to visit her. Due to such behavior, due to such nature, no one wanted to meet her. Nobody wanted to visit her. Then one day Meena was transferred to Bombay and soon we all forgot about her. Then the writer said that one day Meena transferred to Bombay. Bombay was the official name of Mumbai until 1995. In 1995, the name Bombay has changed to Mumbai. Okay, this is all about the lady Meena. Sudha Murthy काय आहेत या इंग्रजी साहित्यातल्या भारतामधल्या थोर लेखिका आहेत. इन्फोसिसचे चेअरमन जे आहेत नारायण मूर्ती यांच्या त्या सुविद्य पत्नी आहेत. त्यांनी अनेक पुस्तकं लिहिली आहेत आणि जो हा पाठ घेतलेला आहे तो पाठ वाईज अँड अदरवाईज या पुस्तकातनं घेतलेला आहे. त्यांनी अतिशय एक सुंदर उदाहरण दिलेलं आहे या पॅसेजमध्ये. त्याचं टायटल आहे अ लेसन इन लाईफ फ्रॉम अ बेगर, म्हणजे भिकाऱ्याकडनं मिळालेला जीवनातला एक धडा असा याचा अर्थ आहे. तर सुधा मूर्ती काय करतात, आपल्या एका मैत्रिणीबद्दल बोलतात जी एल आय सी ऑफिसर आहे, चांगला पगार आहे, पण तिचा एकच प्रॉब्लेम आहे, ती कधीही पॉझिटिव्ह बोलत नाही. नेहमी काय असते, सारखं दुःखी असते, उदास असते. तिला कुठल्याही विषयावर बोला, कुठल्याही व्यक्तीबद्दल बोला, त्यांच्याबद्दल ती पॉझिटिव्ह कॉमेंट अजिबात देत नाही. मग इथं दोन तीन उदाहरणं देतात लेखिका की मीनाला म्हटलं की मीना राकेश वर्गामध्ये पहिला आलेला आहे, तुला माहीत आहे का? असं म्हटल्यानंतर आपण काय म्हणतो रे जनरली की वा खूप छान, किती हुशार मुलगा आहे. पण तिसरं रिमार्क काय असणार आहे, त्याच्यात काय एवढं, त्याचे बाबा काय आहेत, शाळेत शिक्षक आहेत, त्याच्यामुळे तो पहिला आला असेल. हे असं नेगेटिव्ह माइंडेड, नेगेटिव्ह ॲटिट्यूडचं बोलणं मीनाचं आहे. एवढंच नाही, जर मीनाला म्हटलं की श्वेता अतिशय सुंदर मुलगी आहे नाही का, तर ती काय म्हणते, तसं काहीच नाही. ज्यावेळेस तट्टू जो असतो रेस कोर्समधला घोडा, त्याचं लहान बेबी, तो लहान असताना देखणा दिसतो, थोडं मोठं होऊ दे, जरा वेळ जाऊ दे, वर्ष जाऊ दे, मग बघ श्वेतासारखी विद्रूप मुलगी कुणीही नसणार आहे, असं या ठिकाणी ती काय करते, नेगेटिव्ह रिमार्क देते, रेस्पॉन्स देते. आणि अशा प्रकारे काय आहे, ज्यावेळेस तिला आणखीन विचारलं की आज खूप फ्रेश दिवस आहे, बाहेर वगैरे जायचं आहे आपण फिरायला, ती काय म्हणते, उलट आज तर काय आहे, ऊन भरपूर आहे, हॉट सन आहे, आणि या ठिकाणी काय आहे, एवढं ऊन आहे, आणि तुला कोण सांगितलं आहे की चालणे हा शरीरासाठी चांगला व्यायाम असतो, म्हणून त्याला काही प्रूफ नाही, असं काय करते या ठिकाणी मीना वगैरे सांगते. लक्ष येतं इथपर्यंत? दॅट वॉज मीना. सी स्टेड अलोन इन अन अपार्टमेंट ॲज हर पॅरेंट्स लिव्ड इन दिल्ली. सी वॉज अन ओनली चाइल्ड अँड हॅड द हॅबिट ऑफ कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट एनिथिंग अँड एव्हरीथिंग. नॅचरली सी वॉजंट अ व्हेरी प्लीजंट कंपनी अँड नोबडी वॉन्टेड टू व्हिजिट हर. देन वन डे मीना वॉज ट्रान्सफर टू बॉम्बे अँड सून वी ऑल फरगॉट अबाउट हर. ओके. मेनी इयर्स लेटर आय फाउंड मायसेल्फ कॉट इन द रेन ॲट बॉम्बेज फ्लोरा फाउंटन. लेट मी टेल यू दॅट मुंबई इज द कॅपिटल सिटी ऑफ महाराष्ट्र अँड इट इज अ व्हेरी बिग सिटी. वन डे रायटर वेंट टू मुंबई अँड वेन सी वॉज ॲट फ्लोरा फाउंटेन इज अ प्लेस इन मुंबई. इट इज ॲट हुतात्मा चौक. इट इज अ हिस्टॉरिकल लँडमार्क. फ्लोरा, वॉट इज, वॉट डज फ्लोरा मीन? फ्लोरा इज अ रोमन गॉडेस. ओके. फ्लोरा फाउंटन इज देअर अँड व्हेन रायटर वॉज ॲट फ्लोरा फाउंटन इट स्टार्टेड रेनिंग अँड दॅट्स वाय सी हॅड टू वेट देअर. इट वॉज पॉरिंग अँड आय डंट हॅव अन अम्ब्रेला. द रायटर डीड नॉट हॅव अन अम्ब्रेला सो सी हॅड टू वेट देअर. आय वॉज स्टँडिंग नियर अकबर अलीज अ पॉप्युलर डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोअर वेटिंग फॉर द रेन टू सबसाइड. टू सबसाइड मीन्स टू सेटल डाऊन ऑर टू स्टॉप. ॲक्च्युली वी ऑल्सो वेन एवर वी गो आउटसाइड अँड इट इज रेनिंग वी हॅव टू स्टॉप ॲट सम स्टोअर सम प्लेसेस अँड वी हॅव टू ऑल्सो वेट टू स्टॉप द रेन. इन द सेम वे वेन द रायटर वेंट टू मुंबई ॲट दॅट टाईम वेन सी वॉज ॲट फ्लोरा फाउंटन इट वॉज रेनिंग अँड सी हॅड टू स्टॉप देअर. सी स्टॉप्ड ॲट अकबर अलीज डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोअर विच इज ॲट दॅट स्क्वेअर. ओके. देन सडनली आय स्पॉटेड मीना. माय फर्स्ट रिॲक्शन वॉज टू रन इवन इन दॅट पॉवरिंग रेन. आय वॉज ॲन्शियस टू अवॉइड बीइंग सीन बाय हर हॅविंग टू लिसन टू हर नेवर एंडिंग कंप्लेंट्स. हाव एवर आय कुडंट इस्केप. सी हॅड ऑलरेडी सीन मी. ओके. ॲक्च्युली सडन वेन सी वॉज स्टँडिंग देअर सडनली सी सॉ मीना हु वॉज हर फ्रेंड. And what was her first reaction? To run, even in that pouring rain. To run away from that lady, because that lady was a negative-minded lady and she had to listen her complaints. And that's why she wanted to escape her, but she had already seen me. Me means she had already seen the writer and that's why she caught hold of my hand warmly. What's more, she was very cheerful. And the writer is telling us that actually she hold her hand and she holds her hand and she is very cheerful. That means, what's more, she was very cheerful on that day. Hey, I'm really excited. It's nice to meet old friends. What are you doing here? Who is saying? Meena is saying. That means Meena was talking positively. I explained that I was in Bombay on an official work. The writer explained that due to my office work, I am here in Bombay. Then stay with me tonight, she said. Let's chat. Do you know that old friends and memories are precious and rare? Here, Meena said that, okay, you are in Mumbai now. Stay with me tonight. For this night, we will chat. We will enjoy. Do you know that old friends and memories are precious and rare? It is a very good thought. We know that whenever we meet our old friends, then we remember our old memories and we become very happy, and that moment is the golden moment for all of us. Meena is saying so. I couldn't believe it. Was this really Meena? I pinched myself hard to be sure it wasn't a dream. The writer pinched herself. Oh, is that Meena? Was this really Meena? Is she really Meena? But Meena was really standing there right in front of me, squeezing my hand, smiling, and she did look happy. Actually, Meena was there in reality, and she had completely changed herself, and she was looking very happy. In the 3 years she had been in Bangalore, I had never once seen her smiling like that. We know that 3 years the writer was with Meena in Bangalore, and she had not seen her smiling. She had not seen her happy. But today she was very happy, she was very cheerful. A few strands of grey in her hair reminded me that years had passed. There were a few wrinkles in her face, but the truth was that she looked more attractive than ever. Actually, the days had passed. That means she had become old. Though there were some wrinkles on her face, but the truth was that she looked more attractive. She looked more cheerful. Finally, I managed to say, "No, Meena, I can't stay with you tonight. I have to attend a dinner. Give me your card and I will keep in touch with you, I promise." Then Sudha Murthy, the writer, said that, "No, Meena, I have to attend a dinner urgently, and that's why give me your card, give your address, give your number, and I will keep in touch with you, I promise." For a moment, Meena looked disappointed. "Let's go and have tea at least," she insisted. She insisted. She forced that, "Okay, you may go, but let us have a tea." Together, she said so. "But Meena, it's pouring. So what? We will buy an umbrella and then go to the Grand Hotel," she said. When writer said that, "But Meena, it is pouring, it is raining. So what? We'll buy a new umbrella and go to the Grand Hotel and enjoy the coffee, enjoy the tea." It was the remark. It was the positive remark by Meena. "We won't get a taxi in this rain," I grumbled. Grumbled means muttered. "We won't get a taxi. So what? We will walk." That means she was giving positive responses to each and every question by the writer. But actually, before 3 years ago, she was a negative-minded lady. She had such type of negative responses. But now, she has completely changed and she is giving positive responses to each and every question. I was very surprised. This wasn't the same Meena I had known. Today, she seemed ready to make any number of adjustments. That means today, she is adjusting each and every situation. We reached the Grand Hotel drenched. Drenched means wet, because it was raining and they had no umbrella with them. That's why they got wet and reached the Grand Hotel. By then, the only thought in my mind was to find out who or what had brought about such a change in the pessimistic Meena I had known. I was quite curious. The writer was very curious to know who changed her, or is there anyone in her life who changed her. She was very curious to know the changes in her. "Tell me, Meena, is there a prince charming who had changed, who has managed to change you so? Meena, tell me, is there any prince in your life who changed you?" Meena was surprised. Meena was surprised by my question. "No, there isn't anyone like that," she said. Meena said that, "No, there isn't anyone like that." Okay, she said. "Then what's the secret of your energy?" I asked, like Tendulkar does in the advertisement. as Tendulkar does in the advertisement, like this, boost is the secret of my energy. Like this, what's the secret of your energy? The writer asked the Meena. Then Meena smiled and said, a beggar changed my life. A beggar changed my life. I was absolutely dumbfounded. Dumbfounded means to be surprised and confused, and she could see it. Actually, the writer was shocked how a beggar can change Meena's mind. That means she was curious to know how a beggar changed Meena's mind, or how a beggar changed Meena's life. Okay, that is the title of our story. Do you remember up to this point? Actually, it is a story, and let me tell you that we have already discussed it in our classes. कळतंय इथपर्यंत तर काय केलं मीनाचा स्वभाव कसा आहे काय नाही रायटरनं सांगितलं आणि मीना काय आहे आपल्या आईवडिलाला एकुलती एक मुलगी होती जी बेंगलोरमध्ये एका अपार्टमेंटमध्ये एकटीच राहायची तिचे आईवडील दिल्लीला राहायचे आणि तिच्या स्वभावामुळे तिला कुणीही भेटायचं नाही तिला कुणीही बोलायचं नाही कारण ती निगेटिव्ह माइंडेड होती आणि अशा प्रकारे 3 वर्ष बेंगलोरमध्ये लेखिकेच्या सहवासामध्ये ती होती आणि नंतर मग त्या मीनाची मुंबईला बदली झाली एके दिवशी असंच रायटर सुधा मूर्ती मुंबईला आल्या आणि त्या दिवशी त्या बॉम्बेच्या फ्लोरा फाउंटन इथं थांबलेल्या होत्या कामानिमित्त तेवढ्यामध्ये पाऊस सुरू झालं आणि पाऊस झाल्यामुळं त्यांच्याकडे अंब्रेला वगैरे काही नव्हती छत्री नव्हती त्यामुळं ती काय केले पाऊस कमी व्हायची वाट बघू लागले बॉम्बे काय आहे मुंबईचं जुनं नाव आहे 1995 पूर्वीचं आणि फ्लोरा फाउंटन हे मुंबईच्या हुतात्मा चौकामध्ये आहे हे हिस्टॉरिकल लँडमार्क आहे आणि फ्लोरा काय आहे रोमन गॉडेस आहे त्यांच्या नावावरनं हे पडलेलं आहे आणि ती काय करते अकबर अली या डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोअर आहे प्रसिद्ध त्या चौकामध्ये फ्लोरा फाउंटेनजवळ त्या ठिकाणी त्या थांबल्या पाऊस कमी व्हायची वाट बघू लागल्या अचानक त्यांना समोर मीना दिसली आणि थोडा वेळ वाटलं की काय करावं चेहरा टर्न करावं मागे बघावं आणि तिला टाळावं कारण तिला भेटल्यानंतर अनंतर तिला वाटणारच नाही उलट ती कंप्लेंट करायला लागेल काहीतरी दुःखदायक सांगायला लागेल पण असं टाळण्याचा प्रयत्न करत असतानाच मीनानं काय केलं असतं या रायटरला पाहिलेलं असतं आणि ती काय करते डायरेक्ट जवळ येऊन तिचा हात पकडते आणि तिला वार्म विश करते आणि ती म्हणते की मी खूप एक्सायटेड झालेली आहे तुला भेटून मला फार आनंद झाला तू इथं कसं काय आहेस ती सांगते की मी कामानिमित्त या ठिकाणी आलेली आहे तर ठीक आहे मग माझ्याकडे काय करतो आज संध्याकाळी थांब आपण भरपूर गप्पा मारू कारण जुने मित्र मैत्रिणी भेटणे म्हणजे काय आहे अतिशय म्हणजे प्रेशियस आणि रेअर आहे असं ती सांगते तर या ठिकाणी जी रायटर आहे सुधा मूर्ती त्यांना हीच मीना आहे का खरं वाटत नाही कारण त्यांनी मीना वेगळी पाहिलेली असते आता मीनामध्ये खूप बदल झालेला आहे तर एवढं आनंदी ती त्यांनी मीनाला कधीही पाहिलं नाही ते मीनाचं निरीक्षण करतात थोडंसं चेहऱ्यावर सुरकुत्या आहेत एक काही केस पांढरे झालेले आहेत पण मीना अगोदरपेक्षा अट्रॅक्टिव्ह चिअरफुल दिसत होती ते सांगतात मग शेवटी म्हणते रायटर म्हणतात लेखिका की मी थांबू शकणार नाही माझं संध्याकाळी एक डिनर आहे तिथं जावं लागेल मला त्यामुळे तू काय कर तुझं कार्ड दे कॉन्टॅक्ट नंबर दे मी तुझ्या टचमध्ये असेन असं सांगतात ठीक आहे म्हणते ते अगं आपण चहा तर घेऊ फक्त चहा तर घेऊ पण पाऊस पडायला लागला ना काय झालं मग आपण नवीन छत्री घेऊन चहा घ्यायला जाऊ अगं टॅक्सी मिळणार नाही आपण चालत जाऊ म्हणतात आणि अशा प्रकारे निगेटिव्ह माइंडेड मीना सगळ्या रायटरच्या प्रश्नाचं पॉझिटिव्ह उत्तर देते आणि ह्या रायटरला हा खूप हेवा वाटतो त्यांना म्हणजे जिज्ञास आहे की माहीत करून घ्यायचं एवढं कसं त्यांच्यामध्ये बदल झाला मीनामध्ये आणि ते दोघेही काय होतात ग्रँड हॉटेलमध्ये भिजतच प्रवेश करतात आणि बसतात चित्रामध्ये दाखवले बा त्याप्रमाणे आणि रायटर आता खूपच क्युरियस आहेत विचारतात की काय तुला म्हणजे कुणी काही जीवनात एखादा मुलगा आला का तुझ्या प्रिन्स आला का राजकुमार आला का तुला एवढं बदल ज्यांनी बदलवलं तसं काहीच नाही म्हणते मग रायटर विचारते व्हॉट्स द सिक्रेट ऑफ युअर एनर्जी जसं तेंडुलकर ॲडव्हर्टाईजमध्ये विचारतो त्या ट्यूनमध्ये मी विचारते म्हणून सांगते रायटर ती सांगते की अ बेगर चेंज माय लाईफ हे ऐकल्याबरोबर रायटर काय केलं म्हणजे अतिशय म्हणजे आश्चर्य वाटलं, त्याच वेळेस गोंधळात सुद्धा पडली की या मीनाच्या जीवनामध्ये बेगरनं कसं काय तिच्या जीवनामध्ये बदल केला हा तिला पडलेला प्रश्न आहे. नाऊ सी द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस पॅसेज ऑर स्टोरी. येस अ बेगर, सी रिपीटेड, ॲज इफ टू रिअश्युअर मी, he was old and used to stay in front of my house with his 5-year-old granddaughter. Yes, now Meena is telling how a beggar changed her life. In front of her house there was a beggar and who was living with a 5-year-old granddaughter. As you know, I was a chronic pessimist. Chronic means extreme pessimist. I used to give my leftovers to this beggar every day. I never spoke to him, nor did he speak to me. Every day, the leftover food was given to that beggar by Meena every day in the evening. Okay. But while doing so, she did not speak a single word to him, or the beggar also did not speak to her. One monsoon day, I looked out of my bedroom window and started cursing the rain. It was raining. One monsoon day, on that day it was raining heavily and Meena was standing at the window and she was looking outside the window and she was cursing the rain. She was blaming the rain. I don't know why I did that, because I wasn't even getting wet. That day I couldn't give the beggar and his granddaughter their daily quota of leftovers. They went hungry, I'm sure. Why she was cursing the rain? Because on that day, she did not have a chance to give leftover food to the beggar and his 5-year-old granddaughter. And she thought that they both may have slept hungry. She was sure on that day. However, what I saw from my window surprised me. The beggar and the young girl were playing on the road because there was no traffic. Now what she said next, that is very important. After some time, when she looked through the window, she saw that the beggar and his granddaughter, they were playing on the road in that rain because there was no traffic, and they were laughing, clapping and screaming joyously as if they were in paradise. Paradise means heaven or an ideal or perfect place. They were playing on the road because due to rain the traffic was not there. They were not only playing, they were laughing loudly, they were clapping, they were screaming joyously as if they were in paradise, in heaven. That means they were very happy, they were extremely happy, they were enjoying the best moments of their life. Hunger and rain did not matter. Though they were hungry, that hunger and rain did not matter to them. Who is telling? Meena is telling such type of story, how the beggar changed her, to the writer. They were totally drenched and totally happy. I envied their zest for life. That means they totally wet and they were totally happy. And the writer envied their zest. Zest means great enjoyment or enthusiasm. Why they are so happy? I am everything, but I am not happy. Now she started complaining, comparing to each other. That scene forced me to look at my own life. I realized I had so many comforts, none of which they had, but they had the most important of all, assets. Assets means a useful and valuable thing, one which I lacked. They knew how to be happy with life as it was. That is very important. Whatever things you have to be happy, you have to be content. I felt ashamed of myself. I even started to make a list of what I had and what I did not have. I found I had more to be grateful for than most people could imagine. That day, I decided to change my attitude towards life using the beggar as my role model. That sight changed Meena's life. Now Meena started comparing the beggar with her. Actually, she had everything, but she was not happy. But the beggar had nothing, but he was very happy. And so she completely changed her and she decided to be happy whatever she had. And she also decided to change her attitude towards life. And she assumed a beggar as her role model. Okay, using the beggar as the role model. After a long pause, I asked Meena how long it had taken her to change. How long it had taken to change you? Once this realization dawned means began to realize. It took me almost 2 years to put the change into effect. Now nothing matters. I am always happy. I find happiness in every small thing, in every situation and in every person. Now Meena is saying that it took 2 years for her to change her completely. From pessimistic Meena to optimistic Meena. From negative minded Meena to positive minded Meena. Then writer asked her the last question. Did you give any Guru Dakshana to your Guru? I asked. The writer asked, did you give any Guru Dakshana? No, unfortunately, by the time I understood things, he was dead. Actually, who was Meena's Guru? The beggar was Meena's Guru. The beggar was Meena's role model. Actually, I did not give any Guru Dakshana to my Guru, because when I realized all these things, when I changed myself totally, till that time, the beggar was dead. But I sponsored his granddaughter to a boarding school as a mark of respect to him. But she had done one thing for that beggar. She sponsored. Sponsored means provide funds for a good purpose. She provided fund for her granddaughter and she took her to the boarding school as a mark of respect to him. This is all about the very nice and inspirational story written by Sudha Murthy. Actually, as I already told you that the story has taken from Wise and Otherwise, the book written by Sudha Murthy. She writes very nice and inspirational stories, novels. Now tell me, what is the message of this story? The message of this story is that we have to create our own paradise, or we must always look at the brighter side of life rather than complaining about things around him. Okay. तर हे शेवटचा जो लास्ट पार्ट आहे, तर लास्ट पार्टमध्ये काय आहे, मीना सांगते की एका भिकाऱ्याने तिचं जीवन कसं बदलवलं. ती सांगते की असंच माझ्या घरासमोर एक भिकार राहत होता आणि जो काय आहे आपल्या एका 5 वर्षाच्या नातीसोबत राहत होता. मी दररोज काय करायचे, त्याला संध्याकाळी उरलेलं अन्न त्याला द्यायचे आणि तो खाऊन झोपायचा. मग एके दिवशी मान्सूनच्या काळामध्ये पाऊस सुरू झाला. मी खिडकीतनं बघू लागले, मी पावसाला दोष देऊ लागले, पण पाऊस काही थांबत नव्हता. मला वाटलं आता तो उपाशी झोपणार, कारण मीही त्याला कधी बोललं नाही, तोही कधी मला बोललं नाही. पण थोड्या वेळानंतर पुढचं जस दृश्य ज्यावेळेस मीना पाहते, त्यावेळेस ती शॉक, तिला धक्काच बसतो, तिला आश्चर्य वाटतं. तो जो भिकारी आहे आणि तिची नात आहे, दोघेही काय असतात, त्या रस्त्यावर खेळत असतात, कारण पावसामुळे ट्रॅफिक नसतं, पाऊस खूप जोराचा पडायला लागला आहे. आणि दोघेही हसायला लागतात, दोघेही टाळ्या वाजवतात, ओरडायला लागतात, तेही कसं आनंदानं, जणू काही ते दोघेही अगदी कसं आहेत, एखाद्या स्वर्गामध्ये आहेत. आणि भुकेचा त्यांचा काही संबंध नाही, ते भूक पूर्ण विसरून गेलेत, ते पूर्ण भिजलेले आहेत, पूर्ण आनंदी आहेत, आणि त्यांचा उत्साहाला अजिबात पारावर नाही, असे या ठिकाणी रायटर सांगते. आणि ते सीन मीनाला पाहून ती मीना चेंज झाली. कम्पेअर करते, त्या भिकाऱ्याकडे काहीच नाही, माझ्याकडे सगळंच आहे, पण तो भिकारी खुश आहे पण मी नाही. आणि अशा प्रकारे तिला स्वतःची लाज वाटते आणि शेवटी काय करते, ती आपला ॲटिट्यूड, आपला स्वभाव चेंज करायचं ठरवते. आणि तेही काय, त्या भिकाऱ्याला रोल मॉडेल समजून, त्या भिकाऱ्याला एक आदर्श व्यक्तिमत्व समजून. आणि मग रायटर विचारते, तुला किती वर्ष लागलं? ती सांगते, 2-1 वर्ष लागले मला सगळं बदलायला. आणि हळूहळू मग मी काय केलं, माझ्यामध्ये बदल झाला. मग लेखिका त्याला मीनाला विचारते की तू काही गुरुदक्षिणा दिली का आपल्या गुरुला? ती सांगते, ज्यावेळेस मला या सगळ्या गोष्टी कळ्या तोपर्यंत तो काय वारलेला होता, त्यांचं डेथ झालेलं होतं. पण एक काहीतरी म्हणून मी काय केलं, त्यांची जी नात होती 5 वर्षाची, तिला मी काय केलं, माझ्या स्वखर्चानं बोर्डिंग हाऊसमध्ये तिला ॲडमिशन मिळवून दिलं. आणि तो सगळा खर्च मी करते ॲज अ टोकन ऑफ रिस्पेक्ट, ॲज अ मार्क ऑफ रिस्पेक्ट म्हणून. तर अशा प्रकारे तर आपणही विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो काय केलं पाहिजे जीवनामध्ये, जे आपल्याकडं आहे त्याच्यामध्ये आनंद मानलं पाहिजे आणि वी मस्ट ऑलवेज लुक ॲट द ब्राईटर साईड ऑफ अवर लाईफ रादर दॅन कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट थिंग्ज अराउंड अस. ओके, दिस इज अ व्हेरी नाईस स्टोरी. ॲक्च्युली वी हॅव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द इंग्लिश वर्कशॉप राईट इन युअर इंग्लिश वर्कशॉप नोटबुक, कम्प्लीट युअर वर्कबुक. ओके, फॉर बेटर अंडरस्टँडिंग रीड दिस स्टोरी अगेन अँड अगेन. ओके, थँक्यू, हॅव अ नाईस डे.